I am going to turn this inverter ceiling fan into testing device for the DC blower motor. These motors are used in many split air conditioners. This motherboard is installed inside this inverter AC-DC ceiling fan. This PCB operates this inverter ceiling fan. I will use this PCB to operate these DC blower motors. Let's see if we can get success in this project or not. The most important thing is that different manufacturers make different DC blower motors. This connector is mounted on each of these motors. Each of the manufacturers makes different connectors for their blower motor. The wires of all the blower motors are arranged differently by each manufacturer. The device I will make will be universally used for all types of DC fan blower motors. This will make it easier to test any indoor DC blower motors. First of all, I will make you understand the connector of this DC blower motor. This connector has an arrangement of 7 wires. But all the blower motors have 5 wires installed in them. This connector has an arrangement of 6 wires. This connector is designed differently, but it also has an arrangement of 7 wires. Some motor connectors also have 5 wires arranged. That connector also has 5 wires inside the connector. Don't get confused with this. Just understand what I am going to tell you. You will have to check the wires through their color coding. The color coding of the wires for some companies' DC blowers can be different, but most blowers have the same colored wires, but in different order. This red colored wire over here. I am writing red over here. We pass 320 or 10 DC volts on this wire. After this, the black wire is installed after a gap of 1 hole in the connector. The black is the ground wire. The next is the blue wire. The blue wire of this motor is placed over here. It is made on the motor diagram as well. The blue wire is the PG wire, which is installed after a gap of 1 hole. I am writing blue with this connector. Next, the white wire is installed with the connector. I am writing with the connector diagram first. White wire is the VCC wire, and VCC means that the bootstrap voltages will be given to this wire. 15 DC volts will flow through this wire of the blower motor. Next is the yellow wire, which I am writing with the diagram. The VSB volts will be given to this wire. The VSB are those operational voltages, through which this motor will start. And the manufacturers use different IPMs inside their DC motors, and the IPM passes different volts in different motors to operate the motor. The voltages ranges from 1.5 to 7.5 DC volts. As this device I will make will be universal, so it will operate all kinds of motors. This circuit has 2 sections. The one section is to operate the circuit with 220 volts, and the other section is 12 volt DC. This section operates the ceiling fan directly through solar panels. As I need 320 volts, 15 volts, 5 volts, and 7 and 8 volts are needed. Let's check all these voltages are available in this circuit board or not. I have passed 220 volts through this circuit. I will check the voltages on its main electric wires. 227 volts are present in this circuit. We need 320 DC volts. See, a bridge rectifier is installed here. And a capacitor is installed with the bridge rectifier. The capacitor is of 400 volts and 68 microfarads. We should get 320 on this capacitor. Let's check that actually 320 volts are present on this capacitor or not. 317 DC volts are flowing through this capacitor, which is enough for our needs. Let's check how many volts are we getting on these capacitors. Almost 15 volts are flowing through this capacitor, which we needed. Now the ground of this capacitor and the ground of these 15 volts capacitors will be joined as a common ground wire. The ground for these 15 volts capacitors is present, but they don't work properly. I have joined 2 wires. Let me explain to you why. The one will be used for the fan. And with the other, I will make a loop. I will solder it. Let's complete the loop wire. I will join it on the negative side of this capacitor. Next, I need 320 DC volts. I will solder a wire with the capacitor. The 320 volts negative and positive wires are ready. Now I need 15 volts. Now I will solder a wire with the positive side of these 15 volts capacitors. I will attach another wire with the ground pin of the capacitor. Now 15 volts of positive and negative cables are ready. I am going to make its further circuit on breadboard. I have attached the positive wire of the 15 volt anywhere in the breadboard. The negative is on the other side. To know whether 15 volts are passing through the circuit or not, I will install an LED with it. I have this 5mm LED which works on 12 volts. It burns out at 15 volts. I will make a potential divider circuit for this purpose to use this LED light, through which the voltages will be dropped, and the LED may not go bad. I will use two 1 kilo ohms resistors. Both resistors are half watt. I have installed one resistor with a positive pin wire of 15 volts. And its adjacent pin with the other hole in the breadboard. The other resistor I am installing with a negative wire of 15 volts. The other end will be joined with the first resistor. The potential divider is ready. Half voltages will be received over here. Let me show you how. 7.47 voltages are flowing across the one resistor. The LED will not go bad now. Check the positive and the negative pins of the LED light and then insert it. The LED light is working fine. Now I will make the next section in the breadboard through the potentiometer. I will increase and decrease the voltages with this potentiometer. The VSP voltages will be passed to the motor from here. Install it anywhere on the breadboard. I will use a potential divider again to control it. Take two resistors for this work. Smaller resistors can also be used. I have a 1 watt resistor in this value, that's why I am using it. This is a 6.8 kilo ohms resistor. Attach one pin of the first resistor with the 15 volts positive pin and the other with the potentiometer any corner pins. I have installed it with the pin on the right side of the potentiometer. The second resistor's pin will be installed with the potentiometer where the first resistor pin is already installed. The second pin of the second resistor is attached to the third pin of the potentiometer. Now I have made another potential divider. Now 7 and 8 volts will flow here. As I need to operate the potentiometer, I will take the ground wire from the 15 volts negative pin and attaching with the potentiometer left pin. Now for the output from the potentiometer. I am attaching a wire with the centered pin of the potentiometer. Now I will attach a wire with the 15 volt pin. The 15 volts wire is ready now. Four connections for the blower motor are ready now. The VSP voltages, the 15 volts, the white wire is ground, and the purple is 320 volts. Now I will attach these wires to the motor. The purple wire I am connecting with the red wire, which is 320 DC volts. The white wire I am connecting with the black wire, which is the ground wire. This brown wire I am connecting with the white wire in the connector, which is the 15 DC volts. The yellow wire is the operation voltages, which I am also connecting with the yellow wire on the connector. I can now operate and run the motor without the feedback wire. Let me show you by running it. One section of this circuit is still left to be made. I will make that too. I have passed electricity to this circuit. The motor has turned on. I can turn off the motor and I can control the speed of the blower motor with the potentiometer. I am rotating the potentiometer, and gradually the speed of the blower is increasing. The motor is running fine. But if the feedback of the motor is bad, how will we know that the feedback has gone bad? So I will make a circuit for that too. I will need an LED and a 6.8 kilo ohms resistor for the feedback circuit. This is the positive and the negative pins of the LED. I will attach it to the breadboard by taking care of the positive and the negative pins. I am attaching the resistor with the negative pin of the LED and the other pin with the empty connection of the breadboard. I will take 15 volts and attach it with the positive pin of the LED. Next, I am attaching a wire with the resistor. This wire will be attached with the PG or feedback of the motor. Now the PG testing circuit is also ready. The red LED is glowing. This means that the circuit is turned on and the electricity is flowing through it. But the blower has not started because the potentiometer is turned off. I will gradually rotate the knob of the potentiometer. The shaft has started to rotate slowly. The LED light for the feedback has started to blink. This means the feedback of the motor is also fine. As I increased the speed of the blower motor, then I couldn't judge the blinking of the LED. Because the speed of the blower has increased, but the light is still turning on and off. So we have got success running the blower with the inverter ceiling fan circuit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.